So this image, I chose the Dark Portal, and that is an object in the World of Warcraft game. It's this huge door, immense. I thought it would be funny if someone were to trick-or-treat the Dark Portal, and if you were to do that, you'd get a piece of candy or something like that, but a door that size, you'd get a huge honking piece of candy. So if this huge honking candy falls out of that Dark Portal, it's going to squish whoever it hits. I use a poker tool that comes with it as well to transfer the image to the pumpkin. I normally start on the outside, the outlines of the entire project, and just start poking away. I would say about 8 to 10 pushpin holes per inch, maybe. And if it's really detailed in a certain area, I'd do a lot more just to be safe, because if you peel it off and you have no idea where to connect the lines, you didn't do enough.
Here I'm using a blunt push pin for finer detail.
The tool I use the most is the X-Acto knife. Then connect the dots that you just pushed with the X-Acto knife and then go from there. And for mine, I never know exactly what it's going to look like. I just kind of come up with it as I go.
The tip of this X-Acto blade is flat, and it's useful to scrape away larger chunks of the pumpkin flesh, and it also leaves behind a nice texture.
The deeper you carve in a pumpkin like this, the brighter it shows through when you shine a bright light through it.
This blade tip has a 45 degree angle, and I use this one the most to create detail. I pay extra attention to areas like this because one slip can cause something to cut away what I otherwise might want to have kept. I've been asked several times, is it worth it, spending hours upon hours carving a pumpkin? My answer to that is, it really is worth it if I win, but even if I don't, it's a hobby of mine, and it's something that I love doing, and I will continue to do. It will be interesting to see what designs I'll do in the future.
Normally, I'll leave the part that I want focused on the most on a pumpkin for the last, because I want that to be the absolute sharpest. The moment I'm done, I'll go start taking pictures of it, because I want the freshest, sharpest pictures I can get. If I don't do it right away, it won't be that crisp. I discovered in the following years that if you just use the brights on your car's headlights, turn them on, go outside, and hold your pumpkin up against the light. You may need a towel to cover any leakage of light that shines out from the sides, but that works the best if you don't have access to a nice light to shine through it.
Here is the completed pumpkin 9 hours later.
the final step is to submit them for the contest.
And wait. Two weeks later, the results are in, and unfortunately I didn't win. Here are some of the pumpkins I was competing against. I did, however, get an honorable mention and the desire to try harder next time.
The good thing about this style is you don't have to do something that's difficult. You can choose something very simple and apply the same concept to it, like a simple face from VeggieTales.
Here, instead of tracing an image, I simply drew it on the flesh of the pumpkin. I wanted the eyes to glow brighter than the rest, so I spent some time here carving deeper. The eyebrows are supposed to be a little bit darker simply because of where they're located, so I left them pretty close to the outer edge of the flesh. Here you might also notice that I'm not using a full pumpkin. The back of it actually rotted away, so I just cut it in half and save the good side so I could show this process. Ending with the mouth, this whole process took about 40 minutes to complete. And here's the final effect.
A normal carved pumpkin will last anywhere from 2 to 3 days before all the edges crumple in and look bad and it's no longer sharp as it used to. The good thing about this style of carving is it lasts from about a week to a week and a half of keeping the lines really crisp.
The only negative thing of this style is that no air gets inside to dry the pumpkin out, so mold loves to grow there. Simply throw the pumpkin away at this stage.
So if you'd like to try this process, things to bear in mind, find a pumpkin, first off. Find an image that you would like to do. Transfer the image to the pumpkin using the poker and push pin process. Connecting the dots after you peel the image off. Scraping away the parts that you want to pull away, etc. Bring out the highlights, take pictures of it. After you're done, select your favorite picture. There you go.
Thanks for watching, and happy carving.